We all are at the center of His will. How can we be tired? One of the things that get the attention of God is heartfelt sacrifice. Abel, heartfelt sacrifice, but envy whipped Cain. I crave your indulgence, please do not go through this life as if you never came. One of the things that is not in abundant supply is time. And what you want to be, you're already becoming. Get used to it. Life is like a game, like a football game. And each and every one of us are in the field. I said life, a game, football game. Each and every one of us are in the field. And at the end of the game, someone must emerge as the winner. And the role you play depends if we will win or we will lose. The role you play is significant. And possibly when you are in the field of play, you hear some words like, life is not fair, life is not fair. Even in the field of play, it is not fair. When someone is down, it is not fair. So you don't just look them passively with an envy eyes, why not render a hand? Raise them up and encourage them and get them back on their feet so we play to win. Because the teamwork makes the dream work. Someone might look and ask, what is this dude trying to communicate to us? What you have to do at that point in time is to comfort them, because we know they are pained. They are pained, but let them be comforted by the outcome. Because in life itself, none of us were promised a smooth ride. We were never promised a smooth ride, but victory is assured. So why be sympathetic about your circumstance instead of you to be visionary about your purpose? Why are you talking about circumstances that won't happen exactly, since you have air flowing through your nostrils, you still have life around you. There are some people who wish they can substitute you so they can play that position that you play. Play it effectively with your life engaged in it. Why do you want to be substituted when you can be the one to score the goals that will give us the point to win the trophy? Some people will ask, what exactly are we playing for? What exactly are we playing for? And some might ask, who is the opponent? We wrestle not against flesh, nor blood, nor principalities, nor power, nor rulers of darkness in high places. Now you know who the opponents are. We are of the world, we came here, but we are not from here. We came from above. And He who is above is above all. He who is above is above all. He watches us, so we cannot let Him down. Please, we can't. And you know the formation of the world that they play with. They play 4-4-2, some play 4-3-2. I don't really care about the 4-4s. When we go under the feet of our coach, this is what he reminds us, that we play with different set of roles. We play with different set of roles. What are we contending for? We are not contending for the Barclays Premiership, even though it lately started. We are not contending for the UEFA Champions League, even though that is what most folk find pleasure doing. We are not contending for the World Cup, even though that is one of the things that get the attention of the world. What we are contending for, that is the trophy, is the souls of men that perish every day. That is the trophy that we are contending for. Because at the end of the day, we will be given a medal. What kind of medals do you want to get? Is it the medals that you participated in the competition? They get you a medal. It will not make any sense to you. But what makes sense to you is when you are given a medal because you won a trophy. That is one of the significant things that should be pulling through your mind every day. Because people find pleasure in the material. Find pleasure in cars and houses and a couple of them things. How many was buried with a car in it? I don't care who the person is. How many were buried with cars? How many were buried with houses? But the influence that we will leave before we go, because definitely you have to leave the pitch. You have to leave the pitch. When your time is up, you have to leave the pitch. We don't know who will come to play next. But for those who want to play, can they look at us as a source of inspiration? That's one of the things that should be navigating through your mind as the day rolls by. That's one of the things that should be pondering in your mind. As youth itself, I have to tell myself truth. Let it be deeper than roof, so at the end of the day, someone will eat from my fruit. So when the day is finally done, when you are all passed on to glory, because this is the first, but to glory, tomorrow to glory. When you are passed on to glory, will God look at you and say, well done, my faithful. To glory, when you pass on to glory, because you know, you've heard about this story, now you pass on to glory. And that is one of the things that matters to us. That's the reason we do what we do with passion. We do it with love. We do it all, expanding to insults that people do around us. But what gives us the courage to move is result. So at the end of the day, I did not come this far just to entice you with words of men enticing wisdom. I'm not here to cage your mind with hard words of sagacity, but to liberate it and grant it what it desires, which is freedom. Because to be a member of a kindred, an added member of a kindred, heavier is the head that wears the crown. How many people have you brought to the kingdom? That should be one of the things that drive you. Because in life, like I said earlier, none of us will promise a smooth ride. But at the end of the day, Victory is assured. Victory is assured, irrespective of the role that you play the defense or you play the attack. And the choir play the attack. The ushers play the wing. And God knows what the pastors do, because their own is significant, we can explain that. But please, when you go to bed today, what kind of medals do you want to wear? Is it the medal that you just participated in the competition? Or the matter that you worry. God bless each and every one.
It's getting more excited, right? Who is more excited than when he came? Praise God. I hope you're ready for the next act. Except you, of course, standing ovation, the clap will not be going to